speed of sound, vocabulary that astounds. From the planet lexicon, watch her villains, here she comes. Faced with a catastrophe, we need the living dictionary. Her superior intellect keeps the crime world in check. Go girl! Huggy faces by her side, vocabulary a mile wide. She'll make sure that crime will pay and throw some mighty words your way. Word up, it's Word Girl. Word up! From the planet lexicon, watch out, villains. Here she comes!
Word Girl!
Listen for the words ricochet and dismayed. Every day for the past week, the city has been gripped by a fever. Soccer fever! It's on everyone's TV.
And to Silva. Silva shoots off the post, into the back of the net. Goal!
Wow, did you see the ball ricochet off the goalpost and into the net?
And did you hear the way that announcer screamed goal? Like, goal!
Hey, you're pretty good at that.
Thank you.
Okay, team, did you see how those professionals play soccer? Well, with just a little practice, I'm sure you can be almost as good as they are.
Mrs. Botsford?
Please, I didn't go through 2 hours of coaching seminar at a hotel ballroom to have you call me Mrs.
Call me Coach. Mrs. Botsford?
Oh.
I don't know if I'm ever gonna be that good.
Violet, don't be dismayed. I already taught my daughter Becky how to kick the ball, and she's getting very good. Becky, why don't you demonstrate?
Okay. Oops.
Whoa, Becky! It's like you have superpowers.
No. Coach Mom, why don't we start practice?
Good idea, Becky. But first, we need to pick a team name.
Oh, what about the unicorns?
How about the butterflies?
Ew.
Ew!
Make it something cool, like the lasers.
Yeah, the lasers! Pew, pew!
Or something tough, like the gorillas.
Yeah, the gorillas!
No, the unicorns, no
butterflies.
It's gotta be something like the monsters.
Now, team, there is an easy way to compromise. We'll be the butterfly, unicorn, laser, gorillas! Ah!
Dr. Two Brains, what's he doing here?
Gentlemen, we've spent all winter cooped up like rats. Sorry, make that mice. But now that spring is upon us, we finally get to carry out our master plan. We're gonna have a picnic in the park every day for the next 3 months. A little bonding exercise.
That's our master plan?
Well, yeah, what's wrong with it?
Well, nothing. Charlie and I love picnics. I just figured we were going to take over the city and turn things into cheese and stuff.
Oh, we can still do that. But now that the weather is nice, wouldn't it be great to relax and sit on the grass and just nibble on my favorite food in the world? Cheese.
Hey, boss, look down there. Some kids are playing soccer where we're supposed to have a picnic.
Oh no. I am so, featured word. What's the featured word?
Dismayed.
Dismayed, right. I am so dismayed to see this. Excuse me, whistle lady. You're all gonna have to get off the field right now.
What?
We're not leaving.
We're not leaving!
What gives you the right to interrupt our soccer practice and tell us to leave, Mr. Two Brains?
Hey, I didn't graduate cheddar cum laude from Fromage University to be called Mr. It's Dr. Two Brains. Anywho, I went down to the City Parks and Recreation Department and reserved this field at this time for the next 3 months.
That is impossible, because I went down to the City Parks and Recreation Department and reserved this field at this time for the next 3 months.
How could we both have the field reserved? The city must have made a mistake.
Becky, let me see that. I'm shocked and dismayed, but it looks like the city did make a mistake. We both have the field reserved.
What should we do?
I can settle this. You live. leave. Bye-bye.
Sorry, Dr. Two Brains, but our soccer team needs to practice.
Practice soccer? Why would you need to practice soccer? There's nothing to it. You just run around and kick a ball.
That's what I keep telling them.
Well, if you think it's so easy, then how about this? We'll challenge you to a game, and the winner gets the field for the next 3 months.
Challenge? Wait, me and my henchmen playing soccer against a bunch of children? We accept your little challenge.
Great! We'll meet back here at this time tomorrow, but until then, we get to use the field to practice.
Yeah, knock yourself out. Practice all you like. You're still gonna lose. Because when it comes to mad athletic skills, no one can beat a brilliant scientist who stays inside all day and eats cheese. Cheese. Picture, please. How's that one? Can I stop smiling?
Handsome as always, boss.
Oh, that's good. Put that on a mouse pad. Mouse pad!
Okay, team. Now we're really gonna have to practice hard to make sure we keep this field.
But, Mrs. Botsford, what if we can't beat him?
We just know.
Come on, everyone. Don't be dismayed.
I'm trying not to be dismayed, but I don't know what dismayed means.
Oh, well, when you feel dismayed, you feel disappointed because something didn't turn out the way you planned. You wanted to play soccer here, but suddenly Dr. Two Brain shows up, and now you're worried that we won't be able to play, so you're dismayed.
You're right. I am dismayed. I mean, I am dismayed.
I'm dismayed, too.
Yeah! Dismayed!
Well, look at the bright side. We still have a whole day to prepare. And I know if we practice really hard and do our best, we can win this game.
Yay!
Yeah!
Butterfly power! Yeah!
The Butterfly Unicorn Laser Gorillas start their practice. Becky passes the ball to Violet. Violet shoots at the goal. A great save by Bob the goalkeeper. Back at practice, Johnson and TJ practice ricocheting the ball off their heads. Now it's after practice. Looks like Becky is having trouble falling asleep.
Of course I am. You keep announcing everything.
Ooh, right. Anyway, nighty-night.
Good night.
The next day, the two teams arrive for the big game. It's the...
Bogue, Butterfly Unicorn Laser Gorillas.
Huh.
And we're the Cheese Eaters, because that's what we'll be doing on this field right after we win the game.
We'll see about that.
Cheese Eaters.
You know how the game works. Each team tries to kick the ball into the other team's goal. The team that scores the most goals wins.
And when someone scores, I get to yell, "Goal!" And here we go. The Cheese Eaters take control of the ball. Two Brain shoots, and it's a goal! Oh, wait. It's a save. Nice work, Bob. But hold on. Becky takes control of the ball. She passes to Violet. All Violet has to do is make the ball ricochet off her head, and she's going to score a... Nope. The game ends in a tie. A 0-0 tie. Great.
Oh, no! How are we going to decide who wins the field?
The rules of soccer say that when there's a tie, we go to a penalty kick.
Penalty kick? What does that mean?
One player from each team will try to score a goal on a free kick. If they miss their free kick and you make your free kick, you win the game.
Excellent. Henchman! Now all you have to do is kick that ball as hard as you possibly can.
Got it.
Was that?
You told me to kick the ball as hard as I could.
I meant into the goal!
Oh. Okay, this means if Becky can kick the ball into their goal, our team will win! You can do it, Becky.
Yeah. Oh, I know I can do it, but I'd be using my superpowers. I want to win this game and help out the team, but I want to do it fair and square. You know what, Mom? I think Violet should kick for our team.
I don't know if that's such a good idea.
I know you can do it. Now come on and kick that ball into the goal.
Here we go. Violet lines up the shot. She kicks the ball. It ricochets off the post. And it's up!
Sorry, Dr. Dr. Two Brains, but we made a deal. We won the game, and that means we get the field.
No matter. You won't have a chance to play soccer once I cover the whole field in cheese balls. Henchman?
I knew this would happen. Come on, Bob. What?
What was that?
I made your cheese balls ricochet into the mouth of Captain Huggy Face. Ricochet means to bounce off something and go in a different direction. And as long as I can ricochet your cheese balls into his mouth, Huggy will keep eating and eating.
You'll never be able to stop my super big cheese ball.
Looks like it's time to put my soccer skills into action. Over, Two Brains. Take them away, officers.
I may be bad, but I sure taste good.
Boy, I sure had to go a long way to find a drinking fountain. Did I miss something?
Wow, Becky, you sure did. Word Girl came and saved the park so we can practice here. Why, it's almost like she's a part of the team.
Yeah, almost.
I think it's time we take our team picture. Everyone say cheese!
Mom, maybe we should say something else, like our team name.
Okay. On the count of three. One, two, three!
Butterfly, unicorn, laser, gorillas!
Raisin gorillas!
And so, once again, Word Girl and Captain Huggy Face save the day. I hope you got a kick out of today's episode. Don't be dismayed that this episode is over, because there are a lot more exciting adventures of Word!
Today's featured words are confess and fluster.
Just another sunny day at City Hall. And look, everyone is waiting to see who will win this year's Citizen of the Year Award.
I'd like to welcome everyone.
Honey, you look so flustered.
Well, I am feeling a bit nervous.
Don't worry, you're a shoo-in to win this year.
Really? You think so?
Oh, come on. Who got the whole town to participate in the Turn Your Trash Into Art project?
I did.
And when the art started to smell, who started the Turn Your Art Back Into Trash project?
That was me, too.
And who planted all those trees on Main Street?
Actually, that was the grocery store manager.
Oh, well, somebody's gonna win.
There we go. Yes, all right.
As mayor, I give out many awards each year, but I must confess, this one is my favorite. And this year, we are going to give the winner the biggest key to the city we ever handed out. Yeah. This year's winner is a father, a lover of art and trash. This year's Citizen of the Year is, everyone's favorite supervillain, Ms. Question! here you go.
Doesn't it seem unusual for a supervillain who just got out of jail to win a Citizen of the Year award?
I can see the headline now. Citizen of the Year goes to Ms. Question, leaving questions unanswered and citizens flustered.
Something's not right here. There's no way Miss Question deserves that award. I mean, think about all the things my dad has done for this town.
I think there's a story here. I'm gonna go look around and see what I can find out.
Thanks, Scoops. Bob and I will go see if we can help my mom get that look off my dad's face.
Later that day, the mayor and Miss Question are having a private meeting.
Okay, Miss Question, now that I gave you the key to the city and made you Citizen of the Year, you cannot tell anyone my secret. If people find out, I'll never get reelected.
Do you really think I'm done with you?
Maybe.
Uh-oh.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Nothing. Nothing at all. Definitely not writing down everything you're saying so I can write a big article for the school newspaper.
You write for the school newspaper?
But since we're all here, I do have a couple questions. Number one, what is going on here?
What? Oh, nothing. I was just congratulating Miss Question on her award. well done, Miss Question.
Is it true that you only gave her the award so she wouldn't tell everyone your secret?
Who said that?
You did.
Right. Well,
What if I were to tell you that the entire city will soon be under my control?
You kinda just did. But the real question is, how will you do it?
May I answer that for you?
Oh, why not?
Well, see, Miss Question is using her powers to get people to confess their innermost secrets to her. I confess to her my biggest, most embarrassing secret. And now she says she will tell everyone if I don't do whatever she says.
What's your big secret, Mr. Mayor?
You're missing the point. The whole idea is that it stays a secret.
Well, then why did you tell her?
Would you like to see how I get my confessions? Now tell me, Scoops, do you have any secrets you'd like to confess to me?
I didn't clean up after my dog yesterday. I made up a new story about a cat in a tree, and I like to sing in the shower.
Anything else?
I collect unicorns. Okay? Uh-oh. Did I just say I collected unicorns? Out loud? Oh, boy.
I can't wait to read the article you wrote exposing how Miss Question managed to steal my dad's award. There's no question about Miss Question. She's the best citizen of the year ever? What? Scoops, how could you write this?
Well, Becky, I can see you're flustered, but there's a lot you don't know about Miss Question. Yep, she's great. A perfect citizen. Did you know she only speaks in questions? Fascinating, really. Yep, quite a gal. Quite a citizen.
Citizen? She's a villain. A super villain.
Okay, I give up. She made me tell her some embarrassing secrets, and some secrets that could get me in big trouble. She said she's gonna tell everyone if I don't do exactly what she says.
What were the secrets, Scoops?
Becky, the whole idea is that they stay secrets.
Did you confess to having a crush on anyone?
Nope. Definitely not that.
Oh!
Look, it's time for me to go home and lie face down in my bed and figure out what to do.
And it's time for a certain superhero and her brave sidekick to find Miss Question and dish out some truth and justice! Right after school is over.
Later, Miss Question is enjoying her newfound popularity poolside.
Would you care for some lemonade, Miss Question? I made it just the way you like it.
Why not?
Word girl!
You? I know what you're up to, Miss Question, and you're not gonna get away with it.
Really?
What's the one secret everyone wants to know? Why don't you confess who you really are, Word Girl? Word Girl, what is your real name?
Sorry, Miss Question. Excuse me, but would you like ice in your drink? Anything else? Fresh fruit? Pigs in a blanket? A pickle, maybe?
Will you please go away? Aren't you supposed to be renovating the town square in my honor?
Right. Sorry. I'm off.
How'd you do that?
You're forgetting that Huggy and I are superheroes. Right, Huggy? Your secret is safe with me, but... Really, Huggy?
Do you really think you can stop me, Word Girl?
Yes, I know I can.
Can you?
Yes, I can.
Really?
Yes, I can.
Are you sure?
I'm doing it now!
Do you realize how many secrets I know?
I'm starting to, yes.
Do you think you can stop them from naming the city after me?
What? They're renaming the city after you?
Come on, Huggy.
Look at all these flustered citizens. They must have all confessed their secrets to Miss Question. How can we free them from her powers?
Will Word Girl stop Ms. Question before they rename the city in her honor? Will Mr. Buttsford ever get his key to the city? Will Ms. Question tell everyone that I have a secret supply of candy hidden in the park?
Where's the candy hidden?
Shouldn't you be saving the day?
Oh, right. Yeah. Why are you replacing that statue with a big question mark?
Because Miss Question told us to.
So, are you doing all this because Miss Question knows your secrets?
Secrets? What secrets?
No comment.
No comment for me, too.
Okay, this has gone too far. Listen, everybody. Don't you see what she's doing to you? She's controlling all of you because she knows your secrets.
What are we supposed to do?
Well, if you confess your secrets to everyone, she won't have any more power over you. She can't tell what's already been told.
Oh.
I'm a little flustered. What does confess mean?
To confess means to tell the truth about something, even if it's embarrassing or you think it will get you in trouble. So if all of you confess your secrets, then you'll be free from Miss Question's power.
You confess first, Word Girl.
Me?
Yes, Word Girl. Why don't you? Do you have anything to confess? Why don't you tell us your secret identity?
Citizens, I have a secret that only Ms. Question knows.
What do you think you're doing?
Confessing. I'm confessing. I sleep holding a stuffed animal every night. His name is Rex, and he's a teddy bear. He's a teddy bear.
I don't always recycle. Huh? What?
I lie about my age.
Well, I buy books that I never read, just so I look smart.
I don't really have lustrous blonde hair.
What's going on?
I want to be a dancer, and this tie is a clip-on.
What are you people doing?
I secretly collect unicorns.
Really?
Boy, it sure feels good to confess that secret. Now I can go back to reporting the news the way I see it, and not the way Ms. Question tells me to write it.
You look a little flustered.
What do you mean by that?
Well, when someone is flustered, it means they're a little irritated, a little upset, a little worried.
Doesn't anyone care that our mayor sleeps with a stuffed animal?
Well, everybody can know. His name is Rex, and he's a teddy bear. And he's quite cuddly.
I guess not.
Should I stay or should I go?
Secrets and then threatening to reveal those secrets if they don't do what you say. Is that against the law? Okay, I thought so.
With Ms. Question headed for another lengthy time out, the city finally gets back to normal.
And now it gives me great pleasure to announce the real citizen of the year.
Here we go.
And the key to the city goes to our citizen of the year, Mr. Tim Botsford!
Yeah! Thank you, this is quite an honor.
Well, I got another confession to make. The key doesn't open anything. And it's made of chocolate. It's Swiss.
I have a confession to make, too. Saying goodbye is my least favorite part of the show. I get so flustered.
Yum! That's a good key.
Tune in next time for another exciting adventure of Word Girl.
Word Girl!
Want more Word Girl? Watch your favorite episodes and test your word power on PBSKidsGo.org. Want Word Girl's word power? Fly over to your local library. Tape not required. Word up!